Hello everyone, my name is Jared Hybart. I am a product manager here at Yokogawa, and today I'll be covering how to calibrate your TB820D with your FLXA402T. First, we're going to cover the zero calibration, which gives your analyzer a baseline. This gets rid of the detector noise as well as the LED noise. This has two different kinds of calibrations you can do. You have a light off calibration, which is where we turn off the LED. This can be used for high NTU applications, over 40 NTU, and this just gets rid of that detector noise. For lower than 40 NTU, which is going to be the vast majority of your applications, we ask that you do a light on with a zero water. And this is a water that has a value of zero NTU, so it's a very filtered water. First thing you want to do when doing a zero calibration is put the analyzer into maintenance mode. First, we'll cover the light off calibration. So we will go into the sensor menu and into maintenance, and you'll see a light source on off toggle. You will click that and the light source will be turned off. This will usually generate a zero or a negative NTU value. This is the detector noise. From here, you can go back and press the back arrow and then press home. Once on the home screen, you can hit the calibration button in the lower left-hand corner and select zero calibration. The calibration screen will come up and will show the measured value as well as a trend line and a back button and a checksability button. Give your measurement a little bit of time to stabilize and stop changing. Once it has, go ahead and press the check stability. This will allow the analyzer to watch the value, and once it sees that it's stable, it will come up as next. This next step will then calculate the zero point on the calibration line and show you your new measured value. If you agree with this measured value and the slope line, you must hit accept to finish the calibration. Now your calibration is stored and you now have a zero calibration. If you're doing a zero water calibration, you want to make sure that your light source is on. So if you have turned the light source off, go back into the sensor menu, into maintenance, and the light source on off, and turn the light source back on. Once we've done that, we can go back to the home screen and click on calibration. Do the same as before, go to zero calibration. Now we can take the top cover off. This will expose the clear window. You want to remove the clear window with the four Phillips head screws on top. These are captive, so they stay with it. Once these are loosened, you can take this clear cover off, which exposes the flow cell. You want to then, with all the valves closed on the analyzer, your inlet, outlet, and drain, you want to use a funnel and slowly fill your flow cell with zero water. You want to fill the flow cell up just past the light source window. You can see this where the light is coming from, just above the upper edge of that window. Once you have filled up the flow cell, you want to give your signal some time to stabilize, because you may have introduced some bubbles. You want to let these settle out before you make your calibration. You can use this time to go ahead and put the green cover back on to seal off the flow cell from any outside light. Now, looking at the display, you can look at your NTU value and wait for that to stabilize. Once it's stabilized, go ahead and press check stability. Once the next button has appeared, you can go ahead and press next. This will then calculate your zero point and show you a new measured value. If this measured value is acceptable, go ahead and click accept, and your zero calibration is complete. From here, you want to go ahead and move on to a span calibration in most cases, so do not take the analyzer out of maintenance mode just yet. For your span calibration, there are two different kinds, one with our check tool, which is included with the analyzer, and another with a NTU solution. Today we're going to cover the use of the check tool. This is the check tool. You can see that this window is slightly opaque. It's not completely see-through, so that is that NTU value that we are going to be measuring. And then there is also a NTU value on the front of it, written on the front. So this is calibrated in the factory and stored in the detector, so that it automatically pulls this specific one. So you want to make sure that you use the same one that came with the analyzer when you're calibrating it. You want to leave your zero water in the analyzer for this portion as well. Again, we want to make sure that our analyzer is in maintenance mode. Click maintenance mode. If it asks if you want to turn it off, just hit cancel and we can go ahead and start the calibration. The calibration that we're going to select here is the calibrate with check tool. Clicking this, you'll see the screen very similar to the zero calibration, but instead of having a zero value for the calibration value, there is a large number, usually in the 30 to 40 NTU range. You want to verify that this number is the same as what is on your check tool that came with the analyzer. If these match up, you can go ahead and in the area where you took out the plastic window before, this check tool slot into that position, and you want to go ahead and just loosely tighten this down. Once you have this tightened down, go ahead and put the green cover back on and wait for your measurement to stabilize. Once it's stabilized, we'll go ahead and say check stability, give the analyzer some time to run its stability check, and when next appears, you'll see the measured value and your calibration value. By hitting next, it will calculate the slope and show you your corrected measurement value, which should be what your check tool is. Click accept, and then you have now stored your span calibration. Now that we have done a zero and span calibration, we can drain the zero water out of the analyzer, close the drain, take the check tool out, and replace it with the clear window. You want to tighten this window down snugly because this will hold pressure if you have pressure in your system. And you want to tighten it down equally. So use a crisscross pattern like you do for your car tire. Once this is tightened down, replace the green cover, and you can now open your inlet and open your outlet and start flowing process through your analyzer. Once your process has been running for a period of time and you see that your NTU value is stable, any bubbles have left the analyzer, you can go ahead and take it out of maintenance mode by clicking the maintenance button on the home screen and saying, yes, I want to take it out of maintenance mode. It will go out and your analyzer is now fully calibrated and reading correctly. Now that concludes the how to calibrate your TB820D. If you have any questions, please visit yokogawa.com or contact our support, and we will get you any information you need and answer any questions you have.